How goes the fishing? Caught anything slippery?
Aye. Our suspicions were well founded. The Serpent Reavers are indeed the culprits.
The plot thickens.
Has there been any movement in Thanalan?
It has been blessedly quiet. Which is to say the Amalja are being no more or less of a nuisance than usual. Summoning Ifrit with such crystals as they have hoarded. Urianje, too, reports not out of the ordinary.
Then we have our explanation.
Your explanation for what, pray tell?
For the recent spate of crystal thefts in Thanalan, we naturally assumed that the trail would lead us back to the Amalja. Yet it did not. It led us across the sea unto Vilbrand.
Vilbrand? There have been reports of increased Sahagin activity of late. Oh gods, they mean to summon Leviathan?
That is the way of it, I fear. Whilst conducting our investigation on behalf of the mineral concern, we came upon evidence implicating the Serpent Reavers. With the aid of the Maelstrom, I was able to verify our suspicions. 'Tis only a matter of time before Leviathan returns to harrow the seas. But there is more. One of the Sahagin, an elder by my judgment, spoke of attaining the gift and knowledge of eternity. Ugh. Disturbance in the ether. If I did not know better, I should think this device defective. And there is the explanation.
Soon, soon it shall begin. Lord shall rise mid surging waves to wash away the finless ones. And I shall be granted the gift and knowledge of eternity, and with the emissary stand equal. Then shall I know no cessation, no oblivion.
Comes this promise of immortality? The emissary? We have outstayed our welcome.
The gift and knowledge.
Are the two of you quite well?
You shared that vision, did you not? Even before the Sahagin made mention of the emissary, I recognized Elidibus's words. He is behind this. But surely it is not within his power to grant the echo.
My lady, unless we act swiftly, Leviathan will rise again. The Admiral has already requested that we intervene to prevent this. Failing that, we are to attend to the Primal's extermination.
She will have our full cooperation. Let us make haste to Limsa Luminsa. I mean to play a part in this mission. Tataru, pray, take charge in my absence.
My lady, are you sure this is wise?
I am aware of the risks, but there is something I must see with mine own eyes. The true nature of the Echo.
Very well. I shall not stand in your way. On the condition that you permit me to accompany you as bodyguard.
Your company is ever welcome, Thancred.
I take it something ill is afoot.
Aye, a primal is about to be loosed upon Eorzea.
A primal?
A godlike being whose very existence is a bane upon the land. We scions of the Seventh Dawn are sworn to put an end to their kind.
Know then that I am learned in the arts of war. In return for the kindness you have shown my people, I would lend you my blade.
It would be most welcome. When contending with a primal, one can... If you crave a more intimate... problems facing Eorzea, this experience is like to provide it. Be sure to come well prepared.
Thank you.
them. They have made thralls of soldiers and civilians both.
Did I miss much? So that is how you fight in the Far East. Mental note, pick no quarrel with Domans. But seriously, if I am to keep up, I must needs forsake elegance for efficiency.
You'll forgive me my lateness.
I've been something of a liability of late, I know. It is high time I set about making amends.
Long have you shriveled sore walkers, tormented our kind. But no more! Your time is at an end! Salt in your wounds, and sea in your lungs. Lord of the world, hearken to our plea. Lord of the world, deliver us from our misery.
Do you feel that?
This sensation. It's the echo.
What?
Such power! It is transcendent!
Thank you.
refuser! I have mastered the gift! I am eternal!
Ship. Hells, take that sea demon. Gather the survivors and get to shore. Leave the wrecks for the pirates. Leviathan wastes no time. The diversionary squadron is lost. For a mercy, 'twould seem the Primal now makes for open sea. But why does he not press his advantage? God save us. He means to unleash a tidal wave. There used to be a hamlet beyond South Tidegate in Western Lanotia. Halfstone it was called. Some years prior to the Maelstrom's founding, Leviathan rose from the briny depths and set about unleashing watery hell upon us. On that occasion, the company of heroes put him down before he could do too much damage. But when the bastard came next, this time in the wake of the calamity, we were not so fortunate. Weary of ravaging our shoreline, he summoned a tidal wave which fair leveled Halfstone and washed the soil away for good measure.
The area was subsequently occupied by the Sahagin.
Aye, the thrice-damned creatures transformed it into a spawning ground for their brood. Given the quantity of crystal stolen to feed him and his legion of thralls, we can be fairly sure that Leviathan is stronger now than in his previous incarnations. If that sea demon is left to wreak havoc, what befell Halfstone may well befall a larger settlement, even Limsa. That cannot happen. The Primal must be stopped.
That was ever our objective, Admiral. But how are we to achieve it? The sea is Leviathan's uncontested domain. The ships of the 3rd Squadron could not close to within 100 yards of the Primal, nor could their cannons pierce his defenses.
I have read the reports, Master Thancred. Our warships may as well have been bloody pleasure barges for all the good they did. Seven hells! Is there no way that we might strike back?
The company of heroes defeated Leviathan, having first lured him into an inlet, but we must needs contend with him upon the open sea. It will avail us little to consult past experience.
Admiral, if I may.
Speak freely, Marshal.
By all accounts, Leviathan's most formidable weapon is the very sea itself. Waves and whirlpools, tides and currents, all these things are his to command. The key to victory, I believe, lies in disarming our foe. This, in effect, is what the company of heroes achieve with their ruse. We cannot lure Leviathan from the sea a second time. But what if we could weaken his hold upon the element of water? I have heard of devices capable of such wonders. They draw upon the power of corrupted crystals, I am told. If mounted upon a ship, such a device might be used to prevent Leviathan from bringing the full force of the sea to bear against us, rendering him no more dangerous than any other sea serpent.
Of course! Cid built a similar device to grant the Enterprise safe passage through Garuda's Tempest, did he not?
Begging your pardon, my lady, but to give credit where it's due, this is something I heard from an old arcanist friend of mine.
It makes little difference who thought of it first, so long as it works. Beg the specifications of this device from your friend, and I shall pass them on to our people at Naldic and Vermelis. But before we proceed any further, I would voice one concern. Piercing Garuda's defenses is one thing. Suppressing Leviathan's attacks, quite another. In matters of science, I am as a babbling babe. But I cannot well imagine that such a feat would be possible without a veritable mountain of corrupted crystals. The question being, do we have a ship big enough to bear such a burden?
Mayhap not, Admiral, but two might. Recall you the tale of Mistbeard's greatest haul? It is said that he lashed two ships together, side by side, the better to bear his plunder. By your leave, we might attempt to repeat the trick. The gods know it would be quicker than building a new vessel.
Mistbeer did this. Truly, Marshal, upon the subject of the Pirate King, you are as a scholar.
Now, from what I have gleaned of these matters, the device will need to be in close and constant proximity to the target. To wit, we must lash our twin vessel to Leviathan. This in itself will be no small feat. Ramming speed will be required. But given the weight of the cargo, that will only be attainable with the aid of a towing vessel. Suffice it to say, the task of piloting said vessel will entail considerable danger, and I would not ask it of another. I volunteer myself.
It will be dangerous for all involved, but we have no better recourse. Very well. Commodore, assemble the remnants of the fleet at Morabee Bay. Give priority to our soundest vessels. The repairs can wait. Storm Marshal Slafirson, command of the operation is yours. I want that twin vessel ready to sail post-haste.
At once, Admiral.
Then there is the small matter of slaying the beast. The fate of Limsa Lominsa rests upon your shoulders once again. Go well, Warrior of Light. Lomensons are sworn to strive, till sea swallows all. And swallow all it would have, had Leviathan prevailed. That we still strive now, we owe in no small part to you. Not for the first time, you have delivered Limsa Lominsa from the wrath of a primal. Never has our nation known a stouter ally. On behalf of my people, I give you my humblest thanks. Tis meet that I give thanks to old Mistbeard, too, for his fine solution. Whatever else he may have been, tis clear he was a resourceful soul. Would that I had a man like him in my service.
Before I set foot in these lands, I had no inkling that the people of Eorzea contended with such mighty foes. Suffice it to say, their existence came as something of a shock, as did